Hello, everyone, and welcome back. The Pokémon White 2 Dual-type Nuzlocke. We are down in the basement of Seaside Cave. The reason we are here is because I was informed multiple times in the comments that you are not... So, okay, the problem with this place was you can catch Tynamo here, right? I really want to catch Tynamo here because we need another Electro-type on this team. But the problem was you can also find Seal in this place. However, in this basement right here, the basement section of Seaside Cave, that is incorrect. There is no chance of finding Seal. And instead, the only Pokemon that's electric or is valid at all that I can catch for my playthrough is Electric. No, I'm not saying the type Electric. That's the Pokemon's name. Electric. And Golduck I already have. So that does not count for this area. I'm showing these wild encounters to start off with, just so you're all aware that there are no other Pokemon on here besides Electric. So I was mistaken before, but it is only applies to this basement here. So now I'm going to search around until I find Electric. I will let you know when I find it. Oh my god, it's about time. This thing took me forever to find. Whatever, alright, we finally found it, Electric. I found a couple of Shuckles along the way. I didn't realize you could find Shuckle down here, but... Yeah, alright, so we're gonna catch Electric, at least hopefully. I'm starting off by paralyzing it because we can paralyze Electro-types in the 5th gen. As we've seen multiple times throughout this playthrough. See? Both of us just got paralyzed. Wonderful, right? So, I probably won't kill it with like a Discharge or a Flash Cannon, but I don't care. I'm not taking a single chance with this thing. This thing is basically our last hope. Our last hope. I'm gonna give it a nickname fitting with that theme. I won't tell you until I get it. But yeah, basically, these are them two. The two people that are fighting each other at this very moment are the last two electric types that will ever be on our team. Because, yeah, there are no more. Speaking of future Pokemon to catch, after this, the only one left is Seal. To clear the air, some people seem to think I am able to catch Poliwag or Poliwhirl into Victory Road. Unfortunately, you are mistaken. That would be, they are saying you can catch it in Rippling Water. But no, that is fishing in Rippling Water. I can't fish. So no, Seal is the last Pokemon. After Electric, Seal is the last Pokemon I can catch, and that will be in the Giant Chasm. And then that's it. That will be our full team at that point. And just another thing, because you've probably seen my team preview on the side, I trained up Tablespoon into Starmie. Now what should we use on this thing? Let's try Luxury Ball, why not? You want it to be happy, right? The last hope? Absolutely nothing. What a joke. I did that training before I had realized Electric was down here. Because the last episode I actually recorded was ages ago. Like a very, very long time ago. We're gonna use Ultra Balls. Screw this. I'm gonna keep the current team I have. But as soon as someone dies, the immediate replacement is going to be this Electric. Without a single doubt. Like, no matter who. It wouldn't make any sense to replace it with anybody else. So, alright. What am I going to name Electric? I'm going to name it... Lumen. Which is the measurement of light. The light at the end of the tunnel. Our last hope. Alright, do we have anyone with dig so we can dig out of here? I don't remember. I think I had Beryl, but Beryl died a couple episodes ago. I know we don't have dig. Do we have escape ropes? Whatever, regardless, I'll get out my own way. I'll meet you back in Humalau, because we gotta go west from there to continue this adventure. Alright, here we are, everyone. Route 22. We were here for a little bit at one point, but we didn't do much. We kinda just came over here, said hello to Terrakion. Colrus came and gave us his Colrus machine. And that was it. So now we're gonna actually do real things here. What does my team look like? Everyone is 56. Okay, so that means Pint is up front. That's who I like to have up front, because... Do I need a reason? Alright, we're gonna fight this backpacker to start things off with. travel the world because I'm looking for danger. Are you dangerous, trainer? I am extremely dangerous because any Pokemon that fights with me has a very high chance of death. So yes, I basically am danger itself. And you have a 49 swine up. That is embarrassing. That is absolutely embarrassing. You should be ashamed of yourself. Wow. Wow. Goodbye. So yeah, we're back with this series. I say back as in there's some sort of gap between episodes for you guys, although there was that 1 week where there was no episodes, but anyway, yeah, I haven't recorded this in a while. So I'm sorry if I say things that are repeats of past things, or if I just don't seem into it as much. Because I'm kind of just like getting, it's kind of like I'm jumping right back into an adventure that I had stopped playing for several weeks. So, yeah, I'm a little unsure of things. I'm well aware of my team and all that stuff. And I know that we're doing fairly well for ourselves. I realize I'm sounding like I say that I forgot everything that happened. No, I didn't forget anything that happened. Just getting back in the swing of things, that's all. Because most of the time I just record a bunch of stuff in a row, so I'm, you know, constantly into it. So anyway, we're just fighting these trainers here. And this is Arcanine. We're seeing a lot of different Pokemon now. The Swinub, that was the first Swinub I think we've seen in this game. And this is obviously the first Arcanine, so I don't know. There's a lot of unique Pokemon, I guess, that they start using. I feel like they have for a while now. I don't know. There's not much to say. I'm just destroying it. Pint pulls together like usual. Excadrill. All right, we'll switch out for that because we're almost low on health. the only one I trust is Tablespoon. How sad is that? Because everyone else is either weak to something Excadrill could possibly have, or I just realized it could also be weak. It could have X-Scissor. But whatever, I'll take my chances. Thurf. And Tablespoon, I have a lot of high hopes for in the future. Just doesn't have a whole lot of use now, at least unique use. It's very good Pokemon, very fast, very strong. It's just, you can't do much that the other people can't do yet. Do already, I mean. But at some point it's gonna know Thunderbolt and Ice Beam, so it's gonna have a lot of coverage. And yeah, but X Potion. And I guess, it doesn't even go anywhere. I will not use another Repel because I'm gonna walk straight to the doorway. Alright, well, I should probably use another Repel when I'm in here. Alright, so I've already looked at everything, like I've said a million times, so I know there's nothing to catch here. Or does this count as the giant chasm? Does this count as the giant chasm? Because if it does, I can catch, Seal here. I didn't think it was here. I thought it was in the cave with Kyurem. Whatever, this bike music is very unfitting for what's going on right now. It's like evil team plasma grunts. Oh, it's the X team plasma. So he's like a spy for us. You're out of here. So N's gonna run after him. Thinks he's so nice. Something you have to do. All right. Well, you do whatever it is you do. Wow. I just ran into a shaking grass dust. I should probably heal Pint. That would probably be a smart decision. Just a thought. What do you guys think? You think that was a smart decision? I think that was a smart decision. Because you never know what might happen. Alright, wow. Shaking grass dust. Shaking grass dust. Keeps jumping out in front of me! And there's a star piece. That was nice. Okay, maybe I don't go down that way yet? Where does this way go? I think this is where I'm supposed to... No! No, this way! Okay, I do want to go this way, though. This will create a shortcut to... although I need strength, don't I? I might need strength to traverse the giant chasm in general. Yeah, because I could use this... I could use strength and move this boulder so I could have a quick shortcut to giant chasm just by flying to Lacunosa. Great. I guess I could technically go get rid of it any time because I have the access to the move deleter. And as long as it's a TM move I get rid of, I can always reteach it. Let's give it to Ounce. Ounce, I'm going to get rid of... Well, Hail or Blizzard are both TMs that I own, so both will be fine right now. Let's get rid of Hail. Just for now. I promise to fly to my... I promise to go to the move deleter, get rid of Strength. And all that stuff before we do any important battles. By that I mean Getsis and stuff. That's the next important battle, at least. So, Giant Chasm. I think this is considered Giant Chasm, so... Maybe it isn't. Maybe Seal is in this water. And somehow Pint has a problem running away from level, from Pokemon 10 levels lower than it. And Pokemon that are rock. So, yeah. We should have Repels up anyway. But, yeah. Okay, so yeah. Like I said, I thought Seal was in the cave with Kyurem. But maybe it's in this cave. Have I seen Seal yet? I have not seen a Seal yet, so I have no way of knowing. I guess I'll look around for a little bit. I need to use Strength. Well, now that we have Strength, I might as well go all out with it. And oh my god! Okay, that's been three dust clouds that have popped up in front of my path. That's really rude. It's very rude of you, Cave, for doing that. So I'm gonna look around in this water. This might be where I catch Seal. I don't know, though. I guess we'll just explore this place while we're at it, because clearly we have to go somewhere in here to get to our destination. I honestly think it's just that path right over there. But whatever. Clearly there's an item here that I can get. Ice Beam! Heck yes! Oh, heck yes! I'm going to teach it to, like, 5 people right now. Like, by 5 people, I mean my 5 water types are all going to learn it right now. Oh, I was so glad I taught Strength. If I had not done that, I would not have gotten Ice Beam. All right, let's get rid of Swift on Tablespoon. Ounce is going to get rid of Aurora Beam because Ice Beam is basically a better version of that move. They're both just special ice attacks. Goodbye, Aurora Beam. Hog said he's gonna learn it instead of Blizzard because that's a more reliable ice move. Blizzard relies on Hail to be active. Ounce is the only one who's really gonna have Hail. And Pint does not need it. Pint, I like Pint's moves. What about Teaspoon? I don't know if Teaspoon needs it, but let's check her anyway. We got Surf, Hex, Hydro Pump, Will-O-Wisp. I can get rid of Hydro Pump, just so I could have a diverse set of moves. Hydro Pump I was keeping, though, because Teaspoon kind of sucks. And I needed some extra power in her attacks to do any real damage. I'll hold off for now. So I guess you three are all that you're gonna get it right now. Tablespoon, Ounce, and Hogshead. Can you please get out? Thank you. Alright, well, that was a very good decision, teaching Strength and going down this thing of water. I'm thinking I should swim up and down this water and look for Seal. So I'm going to do that real quick. I'll let you know when I give up. Or don't find anything. There he is! We found her! It's a female Seal. Wow. This is it, guys. That's the last Pokemon we will catch this entire playthrough. Let's try a quick ball on it. That's all, folks. All the Pokemon we currently have are the only Pokemon we'll ever have from now until the end. Will we be able to do it? Will we be able to triumph over Team Plasma and whoever the heck the champion is, even though I spoiled it at one point? What should I nickname Seal? Hold on. Alright, guys, this is the very last Pokemon. It's going to be sort of named after our very first Pokemon. Our very first one was Leader. Leader, you know, a single liter of water. This is, if I can type, that would be great. The deciliter. So a deciliter is, you know, a sub-measurement of liter. But it sounds like you're destroying something. You're the deciliter. You know? Destruction? To decimate something? But, you know, technically decimate only means to destroy 1/10 of something. Did you know that? So, yeah. Not only did I want to reference it to my very first Pokemon of this playthrough, but, you know, it sounds like an actual, like, powerful name, and I used the different spelling this time. I used it in the British spelling, or maybe it's all of Europe, or maybe it's just the whole world, other than America. I don't know. It's some other place of the world that spells it R-E instead of E-R. So that's the spelling I decided to go with this time, just so I've used both. And so it's a little bit different than our original leader. Alright, Hugh is yelling at this large group of people. I don't know if that's gonna help. Or protect what's important, hurt, blah blah blah, time to fight now, you're just a kid, quit trying to act so cool! Like, seriously. No one's gonna enter the friggin' frigate! Get the friggin' out of here! That sentence almost worked, but it didn't quite. And I didn't really want to start with Watt. But whatever, I guess he'll do fine. Oh, and it's not a double battle. Okay. I thought it was going to be a double battle with Hugh helping us. I guess not. Alright, Watt. Yeah, we should have no problem here. See, the one thing now I have to worry about is levels. Oh, I'm surprised he didn't kill that thing in one hit. Whatever, it got paralyzed and couldn't attack. Sonic Boom! Yeah, I don't know yet what I'm gonna make my level limit for the Elite Four, if I even make it that far. Because you never know, Getsis could sweep me. And cure him for that matter. I just realized I could use my Master Ball on Seal. I should have done that just to be funny, but I didn't think of it. Because that's the last thing I'm gonna catch. It's not like I'm gonna use it on something. Whatever, I'll save it for in case I have to catch a legendary in post-game, just to transfer it to my main game or something. So yeah. I don't know what level Getsis' Pokemon are at. I guess I'll look it up before I fight him, just so I know what I'm up against, but... At the moment, I don't plan to do any more training unless someone dies and I need them to catch up. Need a new member to catch up, at least. Yay, Max Revives! Those will totally help us! Like, so much. You have no idea. Their backup has arrived? Oh, just those two? This is not gonna be a problem. Blah, blah, blah. Determination falters! We can accomplish anything! Or nothing. I don't remember. I don't know. I should have been reading more closely. Lightlet is a possession of the Shadow Triad. The Dark Warriors appear silently. Appeal silently? Okay. I guess because they're ninjas. Blah, 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 we're the side of justice, but no, we are on the side of evil, so we will stop the evil and stuff. Alright, let's put a repel so we don't have to deal with this, stupid wild Pokemon stuff. Well, I just realized I have a Thunderstone. I'm gonna need that to evolve the electric. That is a very good thing that I have that. Fine, go back up front. Alright, we're gonna get this item over here. It is Razor Claw. That boosts critical hit ratios and can evolve Sneasel. Neither of which sound that important right now. Alright, time to enter the friggin' frigate, part 2. And there's a mini ice puzzle on our way. It's not really an ice puzzle, it's more like a keep picking a direction to go until you go the right direction. And I think he was fighting everyone this way. We go south this time. We completed the north end of the frigate. Yeah, there was a guy that was asleep right here, but now he's suddenly gone. So, oh, I see what's gonna happen. Alright, I didn't think about who I had in my second slot, so this might not be good. Whatever, I'm sure we'll be fine. One of our two members is Pint. Oh, they have a full team of six altogether, but they are basic Pokemon. They're not evolved. You know, maybe I should fly back and teach Blizzard back, or Hail back to Ounce. I think I'm done with Strength already. You use Return on Scraggy. You use Ice Beam on Scraggy. Yeah, I should probably do that. This is probably the last battle I'm going to do this episode, so I will definitely do that between this episode and next. Because I don't think I need Strength anymore. I think I'm done with it already. It's got its use already. I made the shortcut back to Lacunosa so I can get back here easily. And I got Seal. What more could I possibly need? Unless it forces me to use it to get past a certain area, then I would need to reteach it, but, yeah, go for Scrafty. Strawbish is not a threat. Frozen, haha! Nice. And Gunk Shot. Ew! Gross. Didn't do very much. And that was a critical hit. How pathetic. Goodbye, Scrafty. Alright, now we got up a Whirlipede. Once we kill this Whirlipede, it's 2 against 1, basically, so... Destroy it! You know, I guess now that I have Ice Beam, having Hail is not that necessary. But come on, Strength I will never use in battle. I might as well have Hail, because... I do plan to use Blizzard for the final battle, or at least Pokemon that are weak to Ice, because... You know, Hail and then constantly spam Blizzard worked out very well for Drayden. So, I don't see why it won't work for another future person we will have to fight. Sludge Bomb! Bleh. Good thing I'm not Fairy-type, for that would be super effective. One-shotted. For those of you that have forgotten, Ounce is holding the metronome. So every time his attack power is boosted every single time he attacks. So that's why, for those of you that are wondering how he's able to sweep Drayden so easily, because of the metronome. He spammed Blizzard the whole time. I don't think he even needed the boost in power to one-shot Fracture and Drudigan. That's who the first two Pokemon were, right? And then Haxorus, yeah. He was way boosted, so... Alright, so that's the end of today's episode. In the next episode, we will go through the friggin' frigate a second time. Although, it's a different section, so it's going to be a completely different puzzle. I'm not a huge fan of this puzzle, just so you're aware. It might take me a little while. But, yes, we will be prepared, and we will destroy Getsis and its friggin' frigate. Thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed. Rock on.